Greetings. This is part 3 discussing the Strong Delusion. We're discussing what is the Strong Delusion, and this is Theory 2. Before I explain Theory number 2, I would like to administer a test for you, dear viewer. Ready? Let's begin. I've been studying Islam for 15 years. It began, like for so many of us, after Islam attacked America on 9/11. There, that is it. The test is over. I hope it was not too stressful. No post-traumatic test syndrome. So let's take a moment and talk about your results. You can grade yourself. I will trust your honesty because it earns you nothing to cheat. If you heard that statement and immediately reacted with the following, "Islam did not attack America. Islam is a religion of peace, like all other religions." "Islam did not attack America. A few bad men have stolen the religion. The terrorists twist and misinterpret the Quran." You have already been deceived. If those thoughts reflexively sprang into your mind, you are already under a strong delusion. You have already accepted the lies that are being used to spread Islam's reach. And you are in grave danger of swallowing the strong delusion hook, line, and sinker. Delusion, a fixed false belief that is resistant to reason or confrontation with actual fact. The idea that Islam is peaceful and not a threat has already been fixed in your mind. The idea that Islam is peaceful is a false claim. Islam is at war with all that is not conquered by Islam. Islam divides the world into two places, two regions: Dar al-Islam, meaning the world of peace, and Dar al-Harb, meaning the world of war. If you cannot follow this logic, you are resisting reason. Do not refuse to consider these actual facts. If those thoughts reflectively sprang into your mind, you are already under a strong delusion. If you honestly failed this test, you still have some time to decide to seek the truth. Now, let us consider the second theory of what may constitute the strong delusion. And perhaps it is better to describe it as a huge lie that will certainly deceive many not interested in the truth. The Bible has already recorded many, many details and aspects of the last days. This includes describing two men who do not serve God, but rather will serve Satan. The Bible names them as the Antichrist and the False Prophet. These men will deceive many, and if possible, even the very elect. Matthew 24:23. "At that time, if anyone says to you, 'Look, here is the Christ,' or 'There he is,' do not believe it. For false Christs and false prophets will appear and perform great signs and wonders that would deceive even the elect, if that were possible. See, I have told you in advance." So if someone tells you, "Look, the Messiah is out in the desert," don't bother to go and look. Or, "Look, he is hiding here," don't believe it. Pay very close attention to this. This is Jesus, the Messiah himself, speaking about future claims of Messiah's return, his own return. And this hints at what I believe is a coming deception. And to be clear, deception is not the same as delusion. Deception is the presentation of the false facts, the false claims, the bold-faced lie. Delusion is the inability to detect the deception, the inability to detect or discern the truth. They work hand in hand, but are not the very same thing. Islam is going to claim that Jesus, called Isa, son of Maryam, is returned to the desert. Matthew 24:26 again. So if someone tells you, look, the Messiah is out in the desert, don't bother to go look. See, I have told you in advance. Islam is going to claim that Jesus, called Isa, son of Maryam, is returned to the desert. That is the lie, the deception. Delusion will be the utter inability to reject this deception, even though this truth may be known in advance. The lie will seem convincing. What is the first thing that pops into your mind to question or challenge this Isa of Islam? If you are Jesus, show us the marks in your hands, feet, and side. Guess what? He's not gonna have any. And he will have an answer to your challenge. I have no marks because I was never crucified. This is just as the Quran says in Surah 4, 157. But the Bible says you were crucified. The Bible was corrupted. The Bible is false. See? I am not the Son of God. Allah has no son. Allah needs no son. Now, all you Christians need to say Shahada and become Muslim. Stop this blasphemy of calling me God. And to people who have never given any thought to the full truth, this will seem an inarguable situation. Hey, you Christians, you need to follow Islam. Are you Christians stupid or evil or what? Don't you know that Jesus himself is in Damascus? He says he's a Muslim, and you need to stop praying to him. You thought Jesus would come back. Well, now he's back. And to people who have been given over to strong delusion, this will seem an inarguable situation, especially when Isa of Islam, son of Maryam, begins to kill Christians who refuse. Then those under strong delusion will have no incentive to even question, let alone reject, this killer. Can you begin to see the power of this lie? Is there anything which might make it stronger, harder to resist? How about a pope welcoming back this Isa of Islam? How about a pope calling for obedience to Isa of Islam? How about a pope calling for unity with Islam? What then, my Catholic brother and sister? Do you follow Christ Jesus in your heart? Or have you abdicated your relationship with God? So if someone tells you, look, the Messiah is out in the desert, don't bother to go and look. Or look, he is hiding here. Don't believe it. See, I have told you in advance. And that is the lion's share of theory 2 regarding strong delusion. It will be an awesomely believable lie about Jesus returning as a Muslim. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.